Hi, welcome to the video on operating system safe state. My name is Hira Shine, and today I am going to discuss one problem which was asked in June 2016, which was based on safe state. So you can get the question from website also. So I have written on the board also, and now I am reading it, and you can note it down. Then we'll solve it. Okay, so let's
suppose there are four processes in execution with 12 instances of a resource R in a system. The maximum need of each process and current allocation are given below. Maximum needs and current allocations are given below, and it says that there are four processes in execution. These are four processes with 12 instances of resource R. Resource R has 12 instances. Okay, there are two types of resources. One is single instance and the other is multi instance. And here it is saying that there are 12 instances of resources. It means it is a multi instance resource. Maximum need of each process and current allocations P1 is 8 and current allocation is 3. P2 has maximum need 9 and current allocation is 4. P3 maximum need is 5 and current allocation is 2. P4 has maximum need of 3 and current allocation is 1. The question asks, with reference to current allocation, is system safe? You have to answer that system is safe or not. If so, what is the safe sequence? Then what is the safe sequence? If it is safe, then what is the safe sequence? And if it is not safe, then you have to say that it is not safe. Okay, so how we'll do that? Let's see. It says that it has four processes, which are P1, P2, P3, P4, in execution with 12 instances of resources. 12 instances of resources means there are total 12 resources are available. Total resources are 12. Okay, it is given, and here it says that P1 requires maximum 8 units of resources, and 3 is already allocated to it, but it needs total 8 resources. So how many resources left, how many resources are needed more by P1? 8 minus 3 will be 5. We'll calculate these things. Future allocation, and name it as future allocation. Okay, so 5, 9 for P2, 9 minus 4 will be 5, and for P3, 5 minus 2 will be 3, for P4, 3 minus 1 will be 2. Okay, so 5, 5, 3, 2. And already we had allocated this much resources. How many are this? 3 plus 4 plus 2 plus 1. 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, 10. Means 10 resources have already been allocated. Resources allocated. And the question says that total we have 12 resources. And 10 resources are allocated. So how many are left now? 2 resources are available only. Free. Says available. Free. Means we have only 2 resources now which is free. 10 is already allocated. So we cannot allocate from there. We can allocate from only these 2 resources. Now this P1 requires 5 more resources, P2 requires 5 more resources, P3 requires 5 more resources, P4 requires 2 resources. So where will start from P4? Let's see whether this, we don't know till now that the system will be in safe state or not. We have to check. Okay, so by how we'll check? By allocating, by allocating the resources which are needed in the future. The resources we are available free to the process which need that much resources so that it can fulfill its requirement. So only two resources are free now, and P4 need two resources for future. So let's start assigning from P4 and see. So if we assign P4 to two resources to P4, so it will get, one is already allocated, two will allocate, so it will get three resources. P4 will get 1 plus 2, 3, and as soon as it gets three resources, its execution will be completed. And after completion, what it has to do? It has to release all these three resources. One was already allocated, two we have now, two will give now, and the total will become three. And as soon as it gets three, it will complete its process execution and it will release these three resources. So now we have three available resources, and from three, which process we can execute, we can complete execution, this one, P3. Let's see P3. P3 already has two allocated and requires three. So let's start assigning three to this. So this will get, it will become five, and P3, as soon as it gets total five resources, it will be executed completely and release its release all these five resources. Now, so now our available resource, free available resource, will become five. Okay, so with five resources, since P1 and P2 both require both future allocation is 5-5, future need or future allocation is 5-5 resources, so we can either execute P2 first or P1 first. And if we execute P2, let's take P2. P2 has already been allocated 4 resources and we have allocating 5 resources, so it will become total 9. So now our, after executing P2, it will also release this 9 resources. So now our available resources will become 9, and in P1 only requires 5 unit of resources. Okay, these are 5 unit of resources, and we are having 9 unit of resources. So we can easily give this 5 resources from this to P1, and P1 also will execute completely. 3 was already given, and 5 plus 3, 8. We had given 9 resources here, 5 from this, 9 resources, so we were left with 4 resources. Okay, and now after completing execution of P1, it will release this 8 resources also, so it will become 12. So it was given that there was only 12 instances of a resource. So we can say that our system is safe. And what was the sequence? Safe sequence was P4, P3, P2, P1, or P4, P3, P1, P2. So it will not be your answer. Option number 1 will not be your answer because it is written that it is no. Second option is yes, P1, P2, P3, P4. It will also be not your answer because first you have to start from P4. And this third, yes, P4, P3, P1, P2. P4, P3, P1, P2. Either you can write P1, P2 or P2, P1. So this option is correct. And let's see fourth option also. Here it is written that yes, P2, P1, P3, P4. This will also be wrong because we cannot start from P2. P2 needs 3 resources, and at the beginning we had only 2 available free resources. So our answer will be this one, third. Okay, so let's see some more problems in the next video. Thanks for watching. If you like my video, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. And if you have any query, you can ask in the comment section or you can ask in the discussion forum also. Thank you.